Hello, I am Luis Sainz. This third video is the second part about the harmonics and their origin. In the last video, I explained the origin of the harmonic currents. And in the present video, I will talk about the harmonic voltages. We should remember that the origin of harmonic currents is the nonlinear loads which consume periodic but non-sinusoidal currents. These currents can be decomposed in several sinusoidal currents of different frequencies. The current of the same frequency as the original one is the fundamental current, while the other sinusoidal waveforms are the harmonics which are introduced in the network by nonlinear loads. According to this, we have in the next screen four different examples of non-sinusoidal currents consumed by nonlinear loads. Up to the left, we have the non-sinusoidal current consumed by discharge lamps, the red waveform, and the non-sinusoidal current consumed by LED lamps, the orange waveform. Down to the left, we have the typical current consumed by single-phase rectifiers. And on the right, we have the typical currents consumed by three-phase rectifiers, depending on the value of the filter inductance. To study the origin of harmonic voltages, we can imagine that we have a sinusoidal supply voltage which feeds a nonlinear and a linear load in this circuit. The nonlinear load consumes a periodic but non-sinusoidal current. Nevertheless, the voltage at the load terminals remains sinusoidal because this voltage is equal to the supply voltage. So it seems that the harmonic voltages are not produced by the harmonic currents injected by nonlinear loads. This is not exactly true. In fact, the harmonic voltages are produced by the presence of nonlinear loads and other network components. So, these harmonic voltages are not produced exclusively by the harmonic currents injected by nonlinear loads. To understand this, let's see the next situation. We have the same circuit as the previous one, but including the impedance of the grid, where we have the voltage door. In this situation, the voltage at the load terminals is equal to the sinusoidal supply voltage minus the voltage drop at the grid impedance. This voltage drop is the impedance time the distorted current consumed by the nonlinear load plus the sinusoidal current consumed by the linear load. As this current is distorted, the voltage drop is also distorted, and the voltage at the load terminals results distorted with harmonics. In conclusion, even there was nonlinear loads in the circuit, there will be no harmonic voltages when the grid has no impedance. On the other hand, the voltages become distorted and contain harmonics when there are nonlinear loads injecting harmonic currents through the impedances of the grid. We can conclude that the origin of harmonic voltages is the presence of harmonic currents injected by nonlinear loads and the impedance of the grid. This means that the harmonic voltages depend on two factors: the Rodman square value of the harmonic currents and the value of the grid impedance. If one of them is high, we will have large values of the harmonic voltages, and these voltages become highly distorted. For example, the value of the impedance depends on the frequency. If we have a peak value of the impedance at one of the frequencies of the harmonic currents injected by the nonlinear loads, we could have an harmonic problem with the voltages. In the next screen, there is an example of a sinusoidal supply voltage which feeds through the impedance of the grid 10 single-phase rectifiers of 2 kW each one, consuming the non-sinusoidal current in the plot. The voltage at the nonlinear load terminals becomes non-sinusoidal due to the distorted currents consumed by the nonlinear load and the impedance of the grid. It can be seen as the load voltage presents a flat zone instead of the peak value of the sinusoidal supply voltage. This flat zone matches with the peak of the current consumed by the single-phase rectifiers. The tables show the characteristics of the current and the voltage waveforms, that is, the Rodmin square value of the current and the phase angle for each harmonic of the current and the voltage. To complete the videos about harmonics and their origins, I'm going to provide you a script in MATLAB code to determine the harmonics of a periodic but non-sinusoidal waveform. Remember that any periodic but non-sinusoidal waveform can be decomposed in a summatory of a sinusoidal waveforms characterized by their Rodmin square value and their phase angle at each harmonic. First, the program reads the data of the waveform and puts time and waveform values in two vectors. After that, it calls the MATLAB function of the Fourier transform and takes out the harmonics from the vector provided by the MATLAB function. Subsequently, the program determines the Rodmin square value and the phase angles of each harmonics and builds the summatory of the sinusoidal functions, recovering the original waveform. At last, the program compares in a plot the original and the recovered waveforms.